I will read from the book of Revelation, chapter 7. And as I read from this, we will listen to Incantation, the band known as Incantation. The song is Anoint the Chosen, and this is provided by NNEX2. Here we go. After this, I saw four angels standing at the four corners of the earth, holding back the four winds of the earth, so that no wind could blow on land or sea or against any tree. Then I saw another angel come up from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels who were given power to damage the land and the sea. He said, "Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God." I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal, 144,000 marked from every tribe of the Israelites, 12,000 from the tribe of Judah, 12,000 from the tribe of Reuben, 12,000 from the tribe of Gad, 12,000 from the tribe of Asher, 12,000 from the tribe of Naphtali, 12,000 from the tribe of Manasseh, 12,000 from the tribe of Simeon, 12,000 from the tribe of Levi, 12,000 from the tribe of Issachar, 12,000 from the tribe of Zebulun, 12,000 from the tribe of Joseph, and 12,000 were marked from the tribe of Benjamin. After this, I had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, from every race, from every people, from every tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne, and also from his Lamb." That ram, his Lamb. All the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshipped God, and exclaimed, "Amen. Blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes and where did they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they stand before God's throne and worship him day and night in his temple. The one who sits on the throne will shelter them. They will not hunger or thirst anymore, nor will the sun or any heat strike them. For the Lamb who is in the center of the throne, will shepherd them and lead them to springs of life-giving water. And that God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Every nation, every race, every tongue, and it doesn't mean those who have been the subject of evil missionaries. No, that's not what it means. Thank you.